look back at the evening, the next thing he wants to do is to watch as a people to compete against him. Any has supporters here? Sorry, sorry, sorry. Praise the Lord. So here comes the woman. Wants to talk to the husband. And you know, women, when they talk, they want to talk in detail. You see, for a woman, a blue bag is not an ordinary blue bag. A blue shirt or a blue dress, no, 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 had it not been for my wife, I wouldn't, you see, I can't stand shopping. Because when I go to a mall, especially in the U.S., I just feel good. But I am married to a very precious woman, and I have four daughters. And they all love shopping. So I learned quickly that in order not to embarrass myself, anytime we go shopping, I drive them up to the booth. I find a comfortable place to sit. And I tell you, here, I'm not moving. If you come and I'm not here, I'm in the washroom. But I need a blue shirt for my, you just buy me a blue shirt. But you see, for a woman, blue is too diverse. Sky blue, navy blue, but white. For me, I thought to my blue is blue. You don't talk to this woman, and imagine your wife had just delivered. The baby said too much. So the whole day, all what she has been doing was probably a call from you, a call to two family members, and baby talk to this baby. That's all what she said. So she's pregnant with words to talk to the husband. Pregnant. You tell me what bread. Oh, I thought you are not going to say, I'm using. Of course. There are times when every man needs okay, first thing to say something. Know that you have 40 words in the back. So the second day, they say 80,000. Third day, after the third day, you were forced out and you close the meeting because you have spoken all your 40,000 words before. So, your woman. For 1 week, you've not spoken. The day she bursts out, that is when the word just, before you speak, she has spoken 50 words. And at times, we blame the woman, but we, the men, must understand that the second most important thing to a woman is communication. The first is affection. One day, our family will talk in detail about when Bishop was speaking. Touch on many of those problems. When your wife tells you, sit down, we have to talk, you better listen to her. You better, don't, you dare not say please tomorrow, you better sit down. The question that too many people ask, what do we talk about? And especially before the marriage, what are the things we should talk about? And one of the things I tell them is, during courtship, every couple, every aspiring young couple into a marriage must distinguish, must understand the distinction between secrecy and privacy. You see, privacy is something you give someone out of respect. Secrecy is something you would hold from another simply because of fear or guilt or something you think that if your man hears that you will be the privacy is when you, of course, you want to go to the bathroom. Of course, you have to go to the bathroom because you don't want your husband to be there. Or at times you want to buy your wife a surprise. Yes, you can do that one time. secrecy when you don't learn and ask God for grace to share the right place at the right time, will one day come back to find you. Understand that you like anything that you share, you need to come back to you. The devil will tell you, don't tell anybody. Of course, there are some people, the moment you share your issues with them, they become GBC. www.com, they take it everywhere. But you must always find somebody you can trust. The moment you confess, when the Bible says confess your sin to one another, the Lord knew what you do. Not until you share some of those principles, it holds you and it puts guilt on you. You see, secrecy in marriages can be destructive. The two were naked. And anytime we read that passage, for many of us, it is just physical nakedness. No. It goes beyond that. In a marriage, there should be no secret between the couple. Spiritually, the two of you, that is why you can never be unequally yoked. It is impossible for you, the man, to have an account your wife doesn't know. You say, don't do that. You have a secret life your wife doesn't know. One day it will come out. This, what are some of the things we should not keep secret before the marriage? Bad things. But it's all good. That's your spouse, you know. You go and marry the man, then marry the woman, then every morning, it becomes so embarrassing. You are owing everybody. Spiritual challenges. We come from a continent where spiritual challenges are so real, and not only here, it's all over the world. Let your wife know the spiritual challenges that are in her family. And because you have not come to know Christ, the two of you, who is better than one? And the three-way part is not even talking. The two of you plus Christ, there is no ancestral test that can rule over your mind. But don't hide it from your wife. When you were young, you had attacks of epilepsy, and you know very well that attacks in first hand. Let your wife know. You had a mental problem in the past when you were at school. You are hiding it. One day when this day comes and you start taking off your clothes, if you tell your wife, she will know what to do. She will. You see, listen. God told the men to love their, and the wife to. You see, when it comes to loving for women, it is natural. And when a woman loves you, she loves you. Women's love for men, they don't struggle. So God didn't tell the woman to love the husband. What he said to the woman is what? Submit. Because for the love is so easy for her. A child when you were at school. If they didn't tell you, it's a different thing. But you say nothing. But one day you and your wife in the pool of the evening, here comes your family. And this child is your DNA. Not in the inside, on the outside. The nose and the forehead of the child is soft. So, that person can't catch their DNA. For a woman, the third most important thing to her in any relationship is trust. And you see, trust is like a glass. And if I drop a glass on a concrete, what happens to the glass? It breaks and scatters. And at first, only Jesus is able to put those pieces together. But some of these things, when you tell your spouse the truth as early as possible, it's better. But another most important thing to never hide from your wife, and I'm saying this out of experience, is impotence. You, the man, you know you are impotent. You know, this one, and you go, you come, you,
the Kingsley prophet will bless the marriage. You know. Then, oh, as for today, you know how we are tired, waiting, and you are giving excuses. This is not something you are believing God is. Of course, our God is a healer, but seek the healing before you marry. Don't marry and expect to receive healing. Are you with me? And I'm saying this because on three occasions in London, we have married people, and the men were not married. And Paul says something very powerful, that to be born as male is divine, but to be a man is a choice. Not everybody is a man. No. But as for male, it is God who made that decision. It is God who brought you to the world. Your mother didn't decide. Of course, these days, they can go and they can separate. They can see which of the sperm is not. Don't disgrace your family, but share the challenges in the family. Communicate well. Anytime your wife talks to you, listen to the emotion behind your words. You see, when a woman is hard pressed and says no, you promise her you are going to take her out. You make her wait at work. If the wedding went to the little put on the foundation and dress well, waiting for you. You told her all her friends will come. When did you say? You told her you are excited about the date. You promised you'll be there 5:30 for the wedding, but suddenly it's 5:30. So from 5 o'clock she starts singing. She sings, 5:25 she gets the coming to 5:30. 29, 32, oh yes, 35, 8. Then you don't turn up, you turn up 47. After she uncle and she says it's okay. And because she says it's okay, you also, what would you like to have then you grab it back? And all the children knew you were going to take her out. Then they asked, but daddy, what happened? She said, you go. Oh. And when you see, for we the men, we must understand this. Very, very few women on the first day will say yes. When they tell you, look at how you perceive them. And now that you've got it, if there is an issue and she says no, you take a no for a no. Always listen to the emotion behind the woman. And when you do that to a woman, submission will become so easy for you. You know, at times, you must so hold your wife, let her whip on your thigh, and with your tongue, lift those things. And let that girl know that you have not just married her for marriage sake, but that she is a help that God has given for you. You know, the time will not permit me to go too far today. But next time when I come, when I speak on romance, you know, I have a 16-year-old daughter. The village just appeared. She's a Nyamiche. God gave her to her. To ask us again. Such an adorable young girl. And when she was 11, in our Bible study, he said, oh, daddy, you are not going to cry. The thing, it was as if somebody had pierced me. The thing went into us and said, daddy, what do you know? What do you know about romance? The baby don't hold that money sense. And the other five money. They've been watching me. And I have stopped, I have become too comfortable in the marriage. And things that I should do, I will no longer do them. I tell you, I will repent. sent in the name of Jesus. And I'm somebody who loves hot water. When I go to the bathroom, the whole place is vapor, my sugar. So when I know my wife is coming, and any time I see she's ready to go, I go there first because I want to be there. And when the mirror is filled with vapor, I take a finger. You are so precious to me. And I write it on the mirror. And anytime I have done that, if your husband is sitting next to you, tell him, I want to say. Hallelujah. Anytime I've done that, my wife comes out of the bathroom singing. Now, shall we read to you, my wife? Is it not a bonus for you? Praise the Lord. A gentleman came to me one day and said, Pastor, how can I eat rice and palm soup every day? Did I hear you right? He said, yeah, Pastor, how can I eat the same food? This is a non-believer. Married to a believer. Because it was too much for my daughter. This faithful Christian. She said, what is this? When you come back to what I said, coach the man for the company. Of course, the man was there. So much adultery in that world. So I look at the things that I said to the man. Number one, if you think you can't eat rice every day, change this tea. Change it. It's as simple as that. Listen, you can eat it with Chinese. You can eat it with palm oil soup. You can eat it with peanut soup. You can cook it as Chinese rice. You can even put sugar in and eat it as rice water. And even when the rice burns, that one is a special biscuit. That one, you chew it like biscuit. So, can I eat that? Oh, yes, of course. Make up a pleasure. Turn that palm, whatever you show me, oil. And also change the meat in the soup. Tell your neighbor it is well. Put your hand on your head. The Lord has been gracious to me and I've been married for 30 years. I pray. I stand with Bishop that may every grace that God has given me over the 30 years in marriage, may every joy that the Lord has given to me, may He open the same door for me. May every favor that God has given me, may a sevenfold of that favor come over your life. May God take any struggles that I have faced in my marriage away. And every blessing, the blessings of good children, may the Lord give it to you. The blessings of good husbands for your children, may the Lord give it to you. The blessings of finances, may the Lord open doors for you. The blessings of open doors, may the Lord open it for you. The blessings of bringing you before great and important people, may the Lord open them for you. The blessings of uncommon ideas, may the Lord bring it to you. May the Lord cause His face to shine upon you and make your marriage strong and your family great. In the mighty name of Jesus, and the people of God shall say, Amen.
Wow. Jesus Christ. How many of you want more?
Woo!
Mama, as you told me, you say, Mama, you told me, you have to bring that for 1 week. Hallelujah.
Oh.
Hey! Praise you.
You know, that is a very powerful program. The community conference, I think, yesterday, there's a man who had this book and people do have an app. I think the bishop of the King Christian Church in Kingsley. So that means that before you leave, I want about 2 questions. Because I don't want you to get into it, because my questions are very, very serious. So if you're ready, just lift up your hands and give me the microphone. Anything you think you need to ask, I'll be like, this passport and this field. You can speak any language.
Sometimes on the dashboard, you realize that certain lights pop up, and it is not because there's any fault with the car. The question is simple. Sometimes our wife makes certain complaints that it is not because we have just done anything wrong. So,
but every man must dwell with the wife according to the Lord. You must know the wife. And the truth about marriage, as the proper Christian, we discover each other each day. And it's true that at times things will pop up on the platform and not cross the line. And at times, occasionally, especially, and when those things, especially when they are in your cycle, they can do things which is not your fault. Every man has to read about the symptoms of the menopause, and I'll put some of that in the book. And so they can do certain things. It's nothing that you have done, but that is when you need the most. That is when you need the most. That is when you have to let them know that, oh, that is fantastic. And not yet. That is why God has given you to you. That's how we are. And the whole world comes against them, against you. You will conquer the whole world because of that one hand that is holding them. It's too special. And you must learn how to use God's word for your life. And where that comes from your heart.
Any other question? The next question. church was about to question. That is the last one. Thank God is married. That's the first time he's going to marry. That is the last one. Children observe and act. But you see, nobody, the question you might always ask yourself is, how will my children tell my story? If your child or your wife talks about you to their friends, when you are not a person, you do speak. And the three most important people who know you very well is your God, your wife, from you knowing your own desires. These are the people who know you very well. So my answer will be to you. Walk your walk. There is nothing excellent you can give your children than to give them a good godly example. Be interested in everything that they are doing. Let your friends be your friends. The Bible, First Corinthians chapter 15, verse 32, do not be deceived. Bow at something, and what you want is still what you need. So you must know every friend who works with your child. Don't just, don't tell me that I'm 16, I'm 18, I'm not as far as you are, but I'm your dad. And as long as you live on that street, your friends, they can't be my friends, but I just know them. I can rest down and talk to them. You can see the balance of the message. But I want to know.